Hello children, today we start with the next topic, multiples. Okay, now to understand this topic multiples, when the division of a dividend leaves no remainder, the dividend is said to be multiple of the divisor. Now what it means is, now suppose let's say you have a number 20 divided by 5. Now when the number 20 is divided by 5, you have 5, 4s are 20 and the remainder is 0. Now in this division, 20 is called as the dividend, 5 is the divisor, 4 is the quotient and the remainder is 0. So when you have such kind of a division, wherein the dividend leaves no remainder, the dividend is said to be a multiple of the divisor. So when I divide 20 by 5, I get 4 as my answer and 0 as a remainder. I can say that 20 is a multiple of 5. Okay. Now, same method, if I divide 20 by 4, I get 4 5s are 20 and the remainder is 0. So here again, 20 is a multiple of 4 because when I divide it, my remainder is 0. 20 is also a multiple of 5. So I have 20 is a multiple of both 5 as well as 4. Now, children, if you remember the previous exercise, we have done factors, right? Now, if I look at this particular question, I can say that 4 as well as 5 are factors of 20. If I ask you to write factors of 20, you will surely write 1, 2, 4, 5, isn't it? So these are the factors and 20 is a multiple of 4 as well as 5. Children, I hope the concept is clear to you. Okay. So 20 is a multiple of 4 as well as 5. 4 and 5 are factors of 20. We go to the next topic, that is divisibility. Now divisibility by 2. Now in your textbook, when I go to page number 47, there is a topic test for divisibility. Now, we learn about test for divisibility by 2, 5 and 10. Now, when do I say that a number is divisible by 2? If you have a number, if there is 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8 in the units place, the number is a multiple of 2 or is exactly divisible by 2. What it means is, suppose if you have numbers like this, 0, 2, 4, 6 and 8 in the units place of any number, then such numbers will be divisible by 2 and therefore they are called as multiples of 2. Now for example, the number 10, we know 2 5s are 10, the number 22, 2 11s are 22, 34, 2 will go 17 times in 34, 26, when I divide 26 by 2, I get 13. 38. When I divide 38 by 2, I get 19. So, all the numbers, all such numbers which have in the units place 0, 2, 4, 6, 8 are divisible by 2. Okay? Or you can also say these numbers are multiples of 2. Okay? Similarly, divisibility by 5. If you have numbers having 0 or 5 in the units place, they are said to be divisible by 5. As in this case, 20, 25, 45, 60. Such numbers have 0 or 5 in the units place and they are divisible by 5. For divisibility by 10, if you have numbers in the units place as 0, then such numbers are said to be divisible by 10. 10 5s are 50, 10 6 are 60. 10 8s are 80, 10 9s are 90. So these are numbers which are divisible by 10. Okay, children, I hope that is clear. We go to problem set 33. Question number 1 in your problem set. Write 5 3-digit numbers that are multiples of 2. So it should be a multiple of 2 and they should be 3-digit numbers. And like that, you have to write 5 3-digit numbers. So, we start from, we know that if it is divisible by 2, the units place should have 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. So, since it's a 3-digit number, so I write 200, 202, 204, 206, 208. Okay. Now, the second question is to write 5 3-digit numbers that are multiples of 5. So, that's since they are multiples of 5, they should either have 0 or 5 in the units place. So, 100, 105, 110, 115 and 120. The third question is to write 5 3-digit numbers which are multiples of 10. And we know for multiples of 10, you must have only 0 in the units place. So, 300, 310, 320, 330, 340. Children, you can write any other numbers also apart from what I have done. There is no problem, provided you have understood how to do it. Okay. Now, the second question is to write 5 numbers that are multiples of 2 as well as 3. Now, in such a case, to get the answer multiples of 2 as well as 3, what you could do is multiply 2 and 3, you get 6. So, which are the numbers which are multiples of 6? You have 6, 12, 18, 24 and 30. If you look at these numbers, you find all of them are multiples of 6. Okay. They are multiples of both 2 as well as 3. We have multiplied 2 and 3, 6 and we have written. But if you look at it, all of them will be multiples of both 2 and 3. See, 2 3s are 6, 3 2s are 6, 2 6s are 12, 3 4s are 12, 2 9s are 18, 3 6 are 18, 2 12s are 24, 3 8s are 24, 2 15s are 30, 3 10s are 30. Okay. So, that's how we get the answer for question number 2. We go to question number 3. Now, question number 3 says, a ribbon is 3 meters long. Can we cut it into 50 centimeter pieces and have nothing left over? Write the reason why or why not. So, you have a ribbon which is 3 meters long. We know 1 meter is how much? 100 centimeters. So, 3 meter means it is 3 into 100, that's 300 centimeters. Now, if I have to cut it into 50 centimeter pieces, what does that mean? I will divide 300 upon 50. My answer is 6. So, if I were to cut a 300 centimeter long ribbon into 50 centimeter pieces, how many pieces would I get? I would get 6 pieces. So, we will get 6 pieces and nothing will be left over. So, that will be your answer. Okay. We go to the next question, number 4. A ribbon is 3 meters long. I need 8 pieces of ribbon, each 40 centimeter long. How many centimeters shorter is the ribbon than the length I need? So, I need 8 pieces of this ribbon and each should be 40 centimeter long. So, totally how many pieces? What is the total length of the ribbon that I need actually? 8 pieces, 40 centimeter long. So, 8 into 40, it's 320 centimeter. But what do I actually have? I have only a 3 meter ribbon. So, that means how many centimeters is it? 3 into 100, 300 centimeter. So, by how much is it falling short? 320 minus 300. So, that's 20 centimeter short. Okay. Children, this is how you do question number 4. Now, for question number 5, I have done it in the textbook. It's a very simple question. If the number given in the table is divisible by the given divisor, put tick in the box. And if it is not, put a cross in the box. So, how you must do this? The first one is done for you. 15, is it divisible by 2? For it to be divisible by 2, you must check whether the units place is 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. If the number is divisible by 0, if the unit place of the number is 0, 2, 4, 6, 8, you can put a tick for the number 2. 15 has 5 in the units place, so it's a cross. 5 in the units place, so 5 you can put a tick. For 10, the units place should be 0, so I put a cross. So, children, like this, you have to check for all the numbers in both the tables and put a cross or a tick accordingly. I'll explain to you again. If units place, if it is 0, 4, 6, 8, 0, 2, 4, 6, 8 in the units place, divisibility by 2, put a tick. If the units place has a 5 or a 0, it will be divisible by 5, so put a 5 tick in the 5's place. For 10, strictly it has to be 0 in the units place, then only put a tick, otherwise they will all be crosses. Children understood? So this is how you need to do question number 5 of problem set 33. So with that, we have completed all questions of problem set 33. We go to the next topic, prime and composite numbers. Now, what are prime and composite numbers? Now, if you look at the table here, we have written factors of these numbers 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And here 11, 12, 16, 19 and 25. When you look at these numbers, what do I observe? The number 1 is a factor for all these numbers, correct? It's a factor for every number that is given. Now, there are some numbers which have only 1 and that particular number as a factor. Now, 3 is 1, 3. 5 is 1, 5. 2 is 1, 2. 11 is 1, 11. 19 is 1, 19. So, for those numbers which have only 2 factors, 1 and the number itself, such numbers are called prime numbers. And there are numbers, of course, which have got more than 1 number as its factor. So, like for example 4, it's got 1, it's got 2 and 4. So it's got more than 2 factors, right? Similarly, look at number 6, it's got 4 numbers as its factors. Look at the number 12, 16, they've got more than 1 number as its factor. And such numbers are called composite numbers. A number which has more than 2 factors is called a composite number. Now what about the number 1? 1 is a number which is neither prime nor composite. It's a unique number. Okay. It's neither prime nor composite. Okay. Now, we go to problem set 34. I'll first explain to you and then I'll tell you how to write it in your classwork. First question. Write all the prime numbers between 1 and 20. Now, this is the answer. Prime numbers between 1 and 20. The first number is 2. Right? Because it has factors 1 and 2. 3, 1 and 3. 5, 7. Why didn't I write 8 and 9? Because 8 has got more than one factor. 1, 2, 4 and 8. What about 9? 1, 3 and 9. So more than 2 factors are not prime, they are composite. 11, 1 and 11. 13 is 1 and 13. 17 is 1 and 17 and 19. So you need numbers between 1 and 20. These are the numbers, prime numbers. Okay. Second question, write all the composite numbers between 21 and 50. So these are the composite numbers which have got more than 2 factors. So these are the numbers. I've written it down. So you can try it out yourself and check whether you get the same answer. Okay. So that's your second question. Next. Go to question number 3. Question number 3. Circle the prime numbers in the list given below. So I have circled it here. 37, 43, 53, 59, 79 and 97. Okay. Which of the prime numbers are even numbers? So children, a prime number which is even is only one number, the number 2. So 2 is only number, prime number which is even. So your answer is 2. So, that's all about problem set 34. Now, when you write in your classwork, how must you write? First thing, when you start writing problem set 33, before you write problem set 33, you are going to write this on page number 46. You will write, when the division of a dividend leaves no remainder, the dividend is said to be a multiple of the divisor. Okay, you will write the heading multiple first and you will write this particular line. Okay, multiple of the divisor. After you write this, you will come to this particular paragraph, divisibility. Test for divisibility. This will be your next topic. Okay, and you will write what is there in this blue box on page number 47. All these three, test for divisibility by 2, by 5 and by 10. All three you will write. After this, you will come to problem set 33. Children, I have explained this how to do. You will do question number 1, 2, 3 and 4. Question number 5, you need to put a tick or a cross with pencil in your textbook. That is enough. No need to write it in your classwork. Then we go to prime and composite numbers. Heading prime and composite numbers. Then write these three lines. Okay, what's a prime number? What's a composite number? Third one is a number which is neither prime nor composite. And then you are going to write problem set 34, question number 1 and 2. Third one circling, you can do it in the textbook. Question number 4, answer 2, you can write it in your textbook. Okay, so with that we finish with problem set 33 as well as 34. Children, please be sincere with your work, be up to date, kindly complete as and when the videos are being sent. Okay, do each day's work properly and keep revising whenever you get time every weekend so that you are clear with your portion. Okay, thank you.